I told you, pteridophytes are the first terrestrial plants. So how do you think this could stay or live on the land? Terrestrial means what? Live on the land. Other two divisions, that is thallophyte and bryophyte, we saw it is in the water or near the water, because the reason is that they don't have the vascular tissue. Xylem and phloem is absent. So they have to live near the water, they have to live in the water to get the water, to get water. Okay, but this pteridophytes, they could live successfully on the land because they are the first plant to develop the vascular tissue. They were the first to develop the vascular tissue. That's why they are the first terrestrial plants. The plant body is differentiated into roots, stem and leaves. In the thallophyta, we see only the flattened structure. In bryophyta, we see root-like structure, stem-like structure, leaf-like structure. Pteridophyte, they have the actual leaf, stem and root. So, the plant body is differentiated into root, stem and leaves. And they have the specialized tissue for the conduction of water and other substances. And examples are Marsilia ferns. You have seen, everybody would have seen. Okay, ferns and horsetails. I have the collection of these pteridophytes. I just make sure that I show those herbarium sheets. So that will help you to identify the plants. Okay, and so all the three we learned. So in the all the three types of plants, we only just discussed about the, whether it has a stem or the leaf, the distinct part, whether it has or not, or it has tissues or not, its vascular tissues are present or not. Next, we didn't discuss about how do they reproduce. In all the three types of plants, whether it is algae, usually you can see even vegetative propagation, that is asexual type of reproduction we see in algae. Fragmentation, that is you just break it into pieces, it becomes new individual. So we find asexual reproduction in algae as well as in bryophytes also, right? But they also sexual reproduction. So how do they reproduce? So when they reproduce sexually, they produce cells called spores. They produce naked embryos called spores. Okay. When these spores are released from the plant, and if it gets a favorable condition, it will grow into the next plant. That is, that's why I said the bryophytes, mosses, usually we can see them when it rains. Because how do they grow there? Because the spores would have been fallen there, and during the hot weather they won't germinate. Okay, the spores will have a protective shell. Okay, protective layer will be there until unless it gets the favorable condition. That is when it starts, when it becomes moist, when it gets enough of water. That's why during rainy season we see them growing. Okay, the algae or the mosses, that is the bryophytes. So even the pteridophytes also, they reproduce by producing spores. And here we don't find out, we cannot find out the their reproductive structure. When we say the reproductive structure of plant, usually what comes to mind is the flower. So we can identify it, right? So it is prominent structure. But in case of thallophyta, bryophyta and pteridophyte, the reproductive organs are very inconspicuous. We cannot make out. It is kind of hidden. The reproductive organ is hidden. So because of which pteridophyta, thallophyta and bryophyta, they come under a group. They come under a group called cryptogamy. Cryptogamy. Okay, what is cryptogamy? Means cryptogamy means which have a hidden reproductive organ. We really cannot make out their reproductive organ. When I say reproductive organ of plant, usually you know that the flowers are the reproductive organ. In case of thallophyta, bryophyta and pteridophyta, if the reproductive organs are inconspicuous, you cannot see, it is hidden, and that's why they are included under the group of cryptogamy. And what you call those plants in which we can identify their reproductive organ. That is the flower we can identify, and the seeds which are produced, it will be either covered by a hard pod or a fruit. They are included under the group called Phenerogamy. So these are the two types of again division. We can see whether the reproductive organs are visible or hidden. Okay, that is, if it is hidden, we say cryptogamy. If it is visible, we can see it. They come under Phenerogamy. So next we'll see the Phenerogamy, that is gymnosperms. So we learned about cryptogams and phenerogams. Cryptogams are what? Those are the plants where their reproductive organs are not visible, they are hidden. They are cryptogams, and they reproduce by producing spores. Now, phenerogams. Phenerogams, their reproductive organs are visible. Okay, so let us see the phenerogams. These are the plants which will have well differentiated reproductive tissue that ultimately produces the seeds. Okay, so they produce the seed, and we can see the reproductive part, which is a flower in case of angiosperms. And what are seeds? Seeds are the result of reproductive process. Seeds are the result of reproductive process. You have learned, right? The flower will contain stamen. The stamen will contain the anther, and the anther contains the male gamete. And when we talk about the ovary contains ovule. Inside the ovule, we find the female gamete. When the male and female gamete will fuse, it will result in the formation of the seed, right? So the seed is the result of the reproductive process. The seed consists of embryos with stored food. The seed will consist of embryo which will have the stored food. You take any bean seed, right? Or the pea, right? When you can open it, you can see those two halves. That contains the stored food. And if you allow it to sprout, you can see the small plant, baby plant present there, right? So the seed consists of the embryo with the stored food, which will help serves for the initial growth of the embryo during germination, because it has to form the leaves, everything. Till then it needs the food. So the seed will have the stored food, which will help in growth of, or which will help in germination. And the seed again can be classified into two, that is naked seed and enclosed seed. If the seed has covered, if the seed is present inside a capsule or a fruit, they are called angiosperms. If the seed has a covering, otherwise it is enclosed in a fruit, right? Whatever fruit we are taking, whether it is mango or the papaya or the tomatoes, right? They are all what? Angiosperm. Okay, the, like fruit in the sense need not be always like, you know, whatever you eat, like raw, that is. That is angiosperm only. Even banana, brinjal, lady's finger, they all are angiosperms, because the seed will be enclosed by a structure that is called fruit. And if the seed is not, if it is not enclosed by a fruit, then we call it naked seeded plant, which we are going to learn under gymnosperm. So there are phenerogams, there are two types. One is gymnosperm, other one is angiosperm. Gymnosperms are the naked seeded plant. Angiosperms are the plants where the seeds, they produce the seed which are covered by a fruit, right? So why they have the covering? Why they don't have a covering? Because gymnosperms are non-flowering plants. They are non-flowering plants. Only if they produce the flower, the fruits are formed, which we'll be learning now.